And welcome to Vinyl Treasures. I'm your host, Johnny G, John Galindo, coming to you live each and every Saturday, only here on Top Shelf. Always want to welcome you to the August 13th, 2016 Vinyl Treasures Show. Want to thank Ramtown Mike for filling in for me last week, as I had some parties to go to out in Long Island, and had some time off. So thank you, Mike, for filling in. I am here on this hot, hot day, really awful day. Heat. You can't do anything outside. I was actually at a cookout. Actually, we were inside. We're not cooking out at my my sister Lori's house in Croton on Hudson, and we were in air conditioning watching some of the Olympics. I was a little bit behind on the show. I had a really difficult week this week, as I was rammed from behind on the Garden State Parkway. I was in a little accident on Friday. It was not good. It really was not, but I'm okay, and my Cadillac's okay. It's got to get fixed, but I'm here to do the Vinyl Treasure Show. We opened up the show from the 50s and early 60s tonight. I forgot to mention that. It's my 1950s and early 60s show this evening. And we opened up with Organist Pianist from Philadelphia, PA. You all know his signature song from 1956, a song called Honky Tonk. That one sounded a little bit like Honky Tonk. Yes, it is. But he recorded a number of tunes on Sid Nathan's King record label. And this is one he wrote from April 1957. Mr. Bill Doggett. Bill Doggett there on King with a song called Number 3. To open up tonight's 50s and 60s edition. I'm glad to be back. Got some cool 45s. I made some copies just before I came on. I'm going to post them on my Facebook page as we continue through the show. Well, enough of my babbling here, but let's start it off. And this is an act I'm sure you all know on Al Silver's Herald record label. The group is out of Mount Vernon, New York. Now, on their debut single, they were released the record as the Mellow Tones, and eventually the song would become a regional hit. It was never really a national hit. It was, but it didn't really do that well. I think in the high 80s, of course. I'm talking about the tune Tonight Tonight. But they were sued by an earlier Mellow Tones group that recorded on the Fascination label. Also came out on George Golder's G label, Rosie Lee. If you remember that tune, they sued the Mellow Tones on Herald to change their name. So, of course, they changed it to the Mellow Kings. And they had to repress the labels. But initially, Tonight Tonight was put out by the Mellow Tones. And it was not the intended A side of the 45. No, that was really the B side. It was the flip side that the DJs were supposed to push, but they did not. The song written by their manager, Dick Levister. And the label wanted this side pushed. So Let's Give It a Spin features Bob Scholl on lead. This is the intended A side, featuring it on a DJ promo Herald, April 57, the Mellow Tones with Do, Baby Do.
Thank you.
April 1957 release there by the Mellow Tones that became the Mellow Kings. I'm sure many of you own that 45 on the Herald record label. And we played the intended A-side of the 45, a song called Do Baby Do. Really the B-side, Tonight is the one. It actually was much more popular later on with the Art LeBeau's Oldies But Goodies original sound albums. And I think WABC here in New York would play Tonight. It would be on all the in the top 10 when CBS FM would do their top 500 of, you know, voters, send in your votes. It would always be in the top 10, that's for sure. Now, the lead singer there, Bob Scholl, in 1975, he would drown in a boating accident. I think his brother was Jerry, I think his name, took over the group because they were singing at all the Richard Nader shows, etc. here in the New York City area. But anyway, that, again, Tonight, a classic sample. We heard the intended A-side by the Mellow Tones. Enough of my babbling here. Let's continue here. Up next, a group from Chicago, Illinois. They had this lone release on Eli Toscano's Cobra label. Now, the lead singer, his name is Sherrard Jones. Now, listen to the cool tenor sax break on this tune here, led by Harold Ashby and his combo. Not an easy 45 to find. It's on the Cobra label out of Chicago, Illinois. This one from August 1956, The Clouds. The Clouds and their tune called Rock and Roll Boogie.
Let's do the rock and roll boogie
all night long.
Let's do the rock and roll boogie
all night long.
Let's do the rock and roll boogie
all night long.
Hey, rock and roll,
rock and roll.
I love to pop for my finger.
My finger.
I love to jitterbug. I love to dance a will and live.
Crazy saxophone on that one there. Those are the Clouds, August 1956. That is their lone release on the Cobra label out of Chicago, Illinois. The Clouds there with a song entitled Rock and Roll Boogie. We play the music chronologically here on the 50s and early 60s edition of the Vinyl Treasure Show. And how about an early side by this great group out of Baltimore, Maryland? This is their fourth release on Sid Nathan's King label. And it's a cover song, believe it or not. A cover song first done by the Four Aces on the Decca label, if you can believe that. But let's give a listen to this version by the Swallows. Features Eddie Rich on lead. We go way back to December of 1951, Sid Nathan's King record label. These are the Swallows with their rendition of the tune, Tell Me Why.
Do, 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 do. I know I'll never be free. What has happened to me? Tell me why. When we dance until three, tell me why. Why my heart couldn't see. I never dreamed of romance, never give it a chance.
When I think of how you looked that day in your gown of silk and lace, should have known the day you came my way that this was the time and the place.
Tell me why I keep fooling my heart when I know it was love from the start. Why don't we give it a try? If you know, tell me why. Tell me. Tell me why.
I'm going to have to send that one out to Dennis Evers, currently in the Top Show Foley Show. I know he likes those early size, and I know he likes Eddie Rich and the Swallows there. December 1951, Sid Nathan's King record label there, their fourth release on King, the Swallows, with their tune called Tell Me Why. But that was a Four Aces. What, Eddie Alberts or Al Alberts recorded that one there, but that's by the Swallows. Johnny G here spinning original vinyl 45s out of my collection. We do it every Saturday. I'm back for the 50s and 60s edition on this hot, hot day here in New York City. Really, all week was hot. It's going to be hot next week, too. You're cooling off with some cool sounds, as I often do here on Saturday nights. We flip over many of the 45s that I played the previous week. Not all, but many we do, and I have quite a few for the tonight show. And on the last 50s edition, I played the B-side of this debut single for this stellar group out of Louisville, Kentucky. You all know, of course, they were known as the Moonglows. It was Alan Freed's Champagne label. I featured the song I've Been Your Dog ever since I've Been Your Man. But let's give a listen to the intended A-side of the 45. Features Harvey Fuqua on lead. We go to the Champagne label out of Cleveland, Ohio. This one from March 1953. These are the Moonglows. I know, Dennis, you'll like this one too. The Moonglows with their tune, I Just Can't Tell No Lie.
I love you, and I will tell the day I die. And I want you, please, pretty baby, 'cause I just can't tell no lie. Remember, yes, when you left me alone to sit and cry, and I said, come back to me, baby, honey, 'cause I just can't tell no lie. Remember me, yes, I'm the one who loved you first. I'm
love you why, and I will tell you the day I die. And I want you, please, pretty baby, cause I just can't tell no lie.
Remember me, yes, I'm the one who loved you more and more. I'm begging, down on your knees, won't you come back to me?
I want you, please, pretty baby, not just can't tell no lie.
Because I
just can't tell no lie.
Swear you know I
just
can't tell you no lie.
Those are the Moon Glows there. The Moon Glows from March 1953. Alan Freed's Champagne label out of Cleveland, Ohio, a 45. I'm sure he played quite a bit on his radio show out in Cleveland there. Those are the Moon Glows with I Just Can't Tell No Lie. John G Can't Tell No Lie. Only play original vinyl every Saturday here on Top Shelf Oldies. All the crackles and pops and hopefully no skips, but I like to play mint records sometimes. I think this next 45 is pretty mint. We make our first trip to the West Coast as the lead singer for this group was originally from Beaumont, Texas, but relocated to San Bernardino as a teenager. Began performing at talent shows sponsored by Johnny Otis in early 1954. And at one of those shows, record mogul George Mottola was in the audience and he was looking for new talent and he took notice of this artist as Mottola set up a recording session and together with band leader Maxwell Davis wrote this song which became the debut single for this lead singer and his name is Mel Williams. It's on George Mottola's Rage label and he was singing lead for a group called The Capris. This one from October of 1954. We go to Rage Records. These are The Capris with Mel Williams on lead and their tune called Ooh-wa.
Ooh-wa. Baby, you're the one for me.
Ooh-wa.
Baby, you were meant for me.
Ooh-wa.
I'm madly in love with you.
Ooh-wa. Ooh-wa.
Loving you is such a treat.
Ooh-wa.
When you kiss, you can't be me.
Ooh-wa.
Tell me that you love me too. I love the way you walk.
Oh.
I love the way you talk.
Uh-huh.
I love the way you hold me tight.
Yeah.
I love the way you squeeze.
Oh.
I love the way you tease.
Ooh-wa.
I love the way you kiss. Good night. Baby, you're the one for me.
Ooh-wa.
Baby, you were meant for me.
Ooh-wa.
Never, never let you go. You kiss good night. Baby, you're the one for me.
Ooh-wa.
You're as fine as you can be.
Ooh-wa.
I
never, never let you go. I never, never let you go. Never, never let you go.
October 1954 there. Group called the Capris. Mel Williams doing lead on that one on the Rage record label. Song entitled Ooh. Now that record started getting airplay and they sold the master to the Decca record label, but they changed their name for that Decca release to Mel Williams and the Monclairs, probably because of the other group called the Capris, and you can guess who that was. They were becoming well known with their Gotham releases, so I think Mottola decided to change the name to the Montclairs, and that's what happened with that one. But this song was the original we just heard on Rage. It was also covered by Buddy Milton and the Twilighters and RPM, which did much better than the original version. John G here spinning original vinyl 45s out of my collection. Let's go to another flip side from the last 50s Vinyl Treasure Show. This time, Joe Leibowitz's premium label out of Linden, New Jersey. We heard the B-side of this 45 by this Brooklyn, New York group called the Montclairs. The side I played was called Give Me a Chance. Now let's give a listen to the intended A-side. Features Arthur Perry on lead. This one from February 56. The Montclairs on premium. Their tune called My Every Dream.
You're in my every dream.
Dreaming.
Well, darling. You go. I need you
by my side.
For you're in my every dream. Now, darling, can't you understand?
February 1956 release there, the Montclairs. The Montclairs on Joe Leibowitz's premium label out of Linden, New Jersey. Song entitled My Every Dream, Arthur Perry on lead. When I talk to Rhythm Records, they say every time they get that record in, it always sells. That is one of the in-demand 45s. Everybody just likes that tune. Don't know, Dennis. I don't know if Premium reissued it. I don't think so. I don't know if this one, if Kreider has this one that has come out as a boot or not. Actually, yes, it does. I'm sorry. Yes, Dennis, this one does come out as a reproduction, I think. But and it's hard to tell on some of these. This one, it makes make sure yours says 45 dash in the dead wax, because what they used to do, a lot of these 45s and 78s, they used to differentiate in the label dead wax. So 45 would dash and matrix would be for the 45s. On the 78s, it would say 78 dash, and this one definitely is on a 78, actually probably much rarer, as you don't often see the 78 of that one. Anyway, Jaji babbling on here. Let's continue. And up next, for a group that had two releases, we talked about the Decca label. Well, here's one on the Decca label, as members of this group were all from the West Coast. They consisted of David Ford and Gaynell Hodge, members of the Four Flames, along with Jesse Belvin and Gaynell's brother, Alex Hodge. And here is the A-side of their second release. Features Gaynell Hodge on lead. These are the Tangiers from July of 56 on Decca, a song called Oh Baby. July 1956 release there. Group called the Tangiers, features Gaynell Hodge on lead on the Decca label. That's a pretty cool bouncy tune there, I'd say. A song called Oh Baby. That's their second release on the Decca label. Of course, they redid the song Tabarin. I think, Dennis, you may know that for sure. They do. I think that was their first release. John G here spinning 1950s and early 60s 45s out of my collection. Got a little bit of a late start here, so let's continue. And on the last 50s edition of the Vinyl Treasure Show, I played a 45 on the ABC Paramount label by a group called The Marvels, who were really, in essence, they were the Dubs. And I featured the up-tempo A-side of the 45, a song called Jump Rock and Roll. But the collectors bought this one for the B-side. It features Richard Blandon on lead. Mine is a white promo DJ. We go back to November of 1956 for the Marvels, a.k.a. the Dubs. Richard Blandon on lead, ABC Paramount Records. The name of the tune is called I Won't Have You Breaking My Heart.
I cry for you, sigh for you. My heart.
What a great record that is there by the Marvels, a.k.a. the Dubs. Richard Blandon on lead there, November 1956 release. Song entitled, I Won't Have You Breaking My Heart. That one there on the ABC Paramount record label. I've seen stock copies of that, which I would have to say would be probably more valuable than the white promos. But I've got this one, really good price. I don't know what it sells for about now. Maybe $600 or $700 for a nice mint copy of that. I think it's just been a while since I've seen that 45 around. Anyway, enough of my babbling here. Let's go back to the West Coast. This time, Jake Porter's Combo record label. I just posted this one up on my Facebook wall. It's the lone release for this group. They were all the members of the group except the lead singer were attending Centennial High School in Corona, California. But they auditioned for Jake Porter, and the result was this lone release, which features Joe Green on lead. Now, the song was written by the tenor of the group. He goes by the name of Don Ballard. Now, this record is easy to find on the second press Combos because they repressed it maybe Slim Rose's days in the early 1960s, but to find the original with small print was very difficult. Mine is not in great, great shape. Let's hear how it sounds, though. It's from October of 56. They're called the New Tones, and for you collectors out there, it's got to be the small print. The New Tones on Combo. Give a listen to their tune. It's called At Midnight.
At midnight.
California here on the Vinyl Treasures Show. That's Jake Porter's Combo label, one of the thousands of labels that your host Johnny G collects. Those are the New Tones. Joe Green on lead for that one. October 1956 release, At Midnight. That is when Johnny G is scheduled to sign off, but sometimes we do go for a little bit longer, as we often do. John G here spinning my original vinyl 45s. It's 1950s and early 60s. We do it every Saturday Saturday here. The last Saturday of the month will be my All 1960 show, although I have a program note on August 24th, a Wednesday night. I'll be filling in for Ramtown Mike on Wednesday from 9 to midnight. I'll be doing a 60s special edition on that Wednesday evening. So if you like 1960s, mid-60s soul and rock and whole lot of sunshine pop, etc., tune in on a Wednesday night. I haven't done a midweek show in a long, long time. I used to occasionally. I've been here on Top Shelf Oldies since what, August of 2005, I think. I've been here on Top Shelf Oldies. Anyway, enough of Johnny G's babbling. Let's continue now. And I know many of you really enjoyed this next group, originally from Harvey, Illinois. And they thrilled us for decades with their cool tunes, starting back with their first release when they were known as the El Rays on the Checker label. I think I have featured that 45 here on the Vinyl Treasure Show, of course. Then they became the Dells. They had 17 releases on Vivian Carter's VJ record label. Here is their sixth release. It was the follow-up to another great tune they do, Why Do You Have to Go? This was the follow-up with Al Smith and his orchestra. We go back to July of 1957, VJ Records, The Dells, with their tune called A Distant Love.
That we lived, I'll never forget. Our love was so true, I'm lost without you, so please come back to me.
Return my love, return my love. My nights are lonely without your love. I love you so.
July 1957 release, the great Dells there, the Dells on Vivian Carter's VJ record label. A Distant Love is the name of the tune. It played really nice too for you collectors out there. VJ Records, a great label to collect, especially the West Coast presses. They have slightly different print than the Sheldon presses, or I guess the Midwest presses, but the Monarch pressing of the Chess, Checker, and VJ Records, they really look pretty cool. And I try to get them on those labels if I can. They're nice hard vinyl too. Anyway, enough of Johnny G's babbling here. Let's continue. Let's go to San Francisco, California. We go to Don Barksdale's Rhythm record label. And on the last 50 show, I played the A side of this 45. It was the Mondello's second release on Rhythm, a song called Daylight Saving Time. Now, the B side is excellent too. It features 15-year-old Alice Jean Wilton on lead. She also co-wrote the tune with the label owner Don Barksdale. Let's go back to June of 1957, the Mondellos on rhythm with their tune called That's What I Call Love. Johnny G gets caught off mic. Yes, we do. That's out of San Francisco. The Don Barksdale's Rhythm record label, June 1957. That's 15-year-old Alice Jean Wilton on lead and the Mondellos on the Rhythm label. That's What I Call Love. That's the B-side of the 45. You listen with the talking there, the resuscitation. I don't know what you call it. It sounds very similar to the letter by the, who does the letter? Don Julian and the Meadowlark. No, Vernon Green and the Medallions, I think, do the letter. As John G loses his mind here for a Saturday evening. Hope you're digging on the tunes here. John G spinning my original vinyl 45s. Let's continue here. Let's stay in California for this rare 45 on Larry Mead and Ray Robinson's Ray label. As this group formed while they were in the Air Force back in 1957, and they had this lone release. Now, the A-side's a pretty cool cover of the song Sunday Kind of Love, but let's give a listen to the flip side, which is an up-tempo from October 57. They're called the Highlanders. The Highlanders on the Rays label, and the tune is called Beg and Steal.
Whoa, 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 I just met a girl that yeah. I'm gonna steal that car and it ain't no coming back. And she says, babe,
B-sides here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. Those are the Highlanders. The Highlanders, October 1957. That's their only release on the Rays label. Beg and Steal. Is that what his baby's name is? Beg and Steal? I don't know here. JG spinning original vinyl 45s on this hot, hot night. Really humid night here in New York City. Really terrible hot weather. Can't even go to the pool with Barbara. It's too hot. Got to stay indoors and play 45s. I'm playing some more here. Let's go to the West Coast again. Lots of West Coast 45s for tonight's show. And here's one on Cy Aronson's and Joe Green's Demon label out of Los Angeles, California. Mostly known for releases by the Olympics, which I like. My Baby Does the Western Movies. I like that song by the Olympics. And also, Jody Reynolds had a big hit on the Demon label, Endless Sleep. But I think those were maybe the top two. Maybe Well All Right, I think, is another one the Olympics had that made some airplay. But definitely not this next one by this gal that goes by the name of Doe Moody. And there is a group backing her up. This one's from February of 58. Give a listen to Doe Moody on Demon and her tune called Crazy Wonderful. On the Demon label from February 1958, her name is Doe Moody. How many gals do you know named Doe? I don't know many gals named Doe. But anyway, that's Doe Moody there on the Demon label. Song entitled Crazy Wonderful. Let's continue here for a Saturday evening. And on the last 50 show, I opened up the vocal portion with a song called Jitterbug by a group called The Blanders. And it's on the Smash label, which was out of Nashville, Tennessee. Pressed by Mercury Records, who would resurrect that Smash label again in 1961. But let's give a spin to the flip side of that 45, which is a ballad and is the intended A side. And there is a writer credit on this side that's very interesting. It's Barry Kay, and he was a Pittsburgh DJ on station WHAS. So I guess the group possibly is out of Pittsburgh, PA, but who really knows? But let's give it a spin. From April of 1958, the Blanders on Smash, their tune called Desert Sands.
This is the song of the desert sand, where
Oh, that was a ballad. It's not. Mid-tempo tune there for the Blanders, April 1958. Desert Sands is the name of that. Pretty nice tune there on the Smash label, Green Label Smash. I remember when I first started collecting and I was coming across these labels, and I was like, well, wait a minute, there's a discrepancy in the number sequence between this Smash label and the Mercury Smash label. And although this one was distributed by Mercury, so these labels, they drive you crazy. That was one thing I did learn when I worked over at Sony Music. And my boss told me that the owners of labels, they didn't know what the hell they were doing with their numbering sequence, etc. And that is a fact for sure. John G spinning original vinyl 45s. We do it every Saturday. We are in the year 1958. Got an ultra rare 45 up next here on Joe Carlton's Carlton Label. I just posted it on my Facebook page. Charlene nor I could find any info on this group. Now, we did find the writers of the song, who are Kenneth Scott, Johnny Brantley, and Leroy Kirkland. Of course, Kirkland very big in the music industry, of course, with his band and then his writing and producing. Now, Johnny Brantley, he was another band leader, and he also had releases on the Carlton label as Johnny Brantley's All-Stars. Now, this group is called the Capitals. They are not the Capitals out of Pittsburgh on the who are on the Cindy label, nor are they the Capitals out of Brooklyn that recorded for the Pet labels. This is probably some other New York group, but something happened with this record that Joe Carlton pulled the record, and I don't know what happened, but it is a pretty rare record. Let's give it a spin from March of 58, the Capitals on Carlton with a song called I Let Her Go.
I let her go.
One of the, I think that might be the hardest record to get on the Carlton label, Joe Carlton's Carlton label out of New York City. Those are the Capitals, the Capitals March 1958, a song called I Let Her Go. I don't know why they pulled that record for some reason, maybe because how it was recorded, because this is a Stoneman copy that something with the recording, it's not that it has surface noise, but reverb or something with it, but something wrong with that recording, and I don't know. It's a great record, though. Too bad that that record never really received any airplay. Anyway, Jaji's spinning original vinyl 45s. Let's continue here. Got another flip side from the last 50s show for this group out of New Haven, Connecticut, known as the Nobles. I played the A side of the 45, a Gus Gossard favorite. For those of you that used to tune in to Gus Gossard in the early 70s, Poor Rock and Roll, that was the side I played. But let's give a spin to the flip side before it goes back down in the no humidity basement. And boy, was that dehumidifier working for the last week for sure. But anyway, it's on Marty Kugel's Click label from May of 58, the Nobles with a B side on Click, a song called Ting-a-ling.
Na 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 la 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 say easy, tingling, ling in my tummy when she says, come on and honey.
says the band will be in tune.
Wah, 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 wah.
Besides here on the Vinyl Treasure Show, the Nobles there, Marty Kugel's Click Label, the flip side of poor rock and roll, song entitled Tingling, that one there from May 1958. Let's stay in 1958, continuing with the flip sides from the last 50s edition. I played a 45 on Leon Renee's Class label by a group called The Blenders. We heard The Blenders, these are The Blenders, a song called My Heart's Desire, a great cool up-tempo song there. The flip is an excellent ballad written by the lead singer. His name is Sammy Vance. And this one from September of 1958, this was the, I think this is the intended, yeah, 2068. This was the intended A side of the 45, The Blenders on Class, with a song called My Little Rose.
So much, so dearly, I can't forget my little rose. You asked me to try and forget you, and I tried to forget you. You said it was only infatuation. No, 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 I'm in love, my, my little rose. That's what I call you, my little, little rose. I never even knew your name, only that you wore
group called The Blenders. The Blenders, September 1958, release on the Class label, Leon Renee's Class record label there, song and tell, My Little Rose. Warren, I have a promo of this too, which is the white promo, and this comes on a black stock and also a maroon stock. I featured it on the black stock. I'm looking for the maroon stock if I can find it. And because I can get a better copy for that stock copy. Anyway, John G babbling on, but Sammy Vance, he wrote that tune, and prior to joining this group, because I think he's doing lead on this, although on the side that I'm going to play this Sammy Vance record, it doesn't sound like him, but it is him. Supposedly it is him. And he has a solo release on Lenora Rupe's Ebb label, and the group backing up is probably that Blenders group we just heard, but Sammy Vance, he also wrote this tune, but it came out prior to that Blenders' My Little Rose. So let's give this one a spin. It's from January 58, Sammy Vance on Ebb, a song called Run, Run, Run. January 1958 release there. Sammy Vance is his name. He wrote the tune on the Ebb label out of Hollywood, California. There, song and title, Run, Run, Run. Jaji not running yet, as I'm checking to see if this CD is running out that I'm recording on the CD. But anyway, we are here spinning 1950s and early 60s 45s out of my collection, and let's continue here. And a group called The Captains, a group out of Washington, D.C., came out with were originally a combination of two gospel groups, the Progressive Four and a group called The Buddies, and they go way back to the 1930s, and there were many generations of those groups. Then sometime in the late 1940s, they called themselves The Captains. I guess before they were The Captains, they were the what I wanted to say was, they, well, messed this up here, I did. The Progressive Four and The Buddies were gospel groups that got together to form The Captains. That's what I wanted to say. And that happened in the late 1930s. And they recorded on labels like DC, Gotham, Dot, and Coral. But by mid-1953, the group broke up. They disbanded. They were no longer in existence. But then in 1958, they were resurrected by Harmon Bethay. And he created this new group of Captains. And their first release came out on the Hollywood label, and he wanted to give them a Spanish presentation, like El Captain. So there's an L apostrophe before the later Captains group. They were called the El Captains. And here is the A side of their first release on Hollywood with Frank Motley's orchestra. It features Lester Britton on lead. This one came out in April of 58 on Hollywood. The El Captains with a song called The Bells Ring Out.
Ding dong, dear Lord above, ding dong, I pray to thee, ding dong, that she'll come back, ding dong, come back to me.
The bells ring out, and you never, never, never leave me. Oh, how they rain. Oh, how they say the bell.
Sweetheart, sing. Bless you, the bells be.
The bells ring high from heaven above. The bells told me you'll be my love. Oh, how they ring. Oh, how they say.
They're called the El Captains. The El Captains from April 1958 on the Hollywood record label, a song called The Bells Ring Out. And that one featured Lester Britton on lead. Now, they would have other releases on the DC label. I think it was picked up by Savoy Records, and they had another one on Anna. They had some on the Loop label and the Sabu label. In the mid-1960s, this group changed their name to Maskmen and the Agents, and Harbin Bethay became the lead singer of the group. I think he also does lead, I think, on the flip side of this one and a couple of the other ones. But anyway, those are the El Captains from April 58, The Bells Ring Out on Hollywood Records. Let's continue here. Got another ultra rare 45 out of New York City. This one on Benny Clark's Stroll label. I was posting this one on my Facebook page, but I wanted to write a little bit about it, but you will hear it first here. And it's on the Stroll label. Now, the group was originally called the Phytones, but because of the Phytones that recorded on the Atlas Angletone label, they were forced to change their name, and they changed their name to the Strolls, of course, for the Stroll label. And on some of the 45s, there is a typed sticker that is glued to the label. That's how mine is. And prior to this release, the group backed up someone by the name of Carl Thomas on the Stroll label. But here is the A side of this very rare 45, and they kind of messed this one up too, because they called the song Down, but then what they did is, on mine, I'll post it on Facebook, their sticker they typed three more Downs and put it on top of the label. It's kind of weird, and you'll check it out. It's from 1959. Let's give it a spin. This is the A-side, The Strolls on Stroll, with a song called Down, 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 Down.
Rock thou's down.
Oh, yeah.
Rock thou's down.
Rock
thou's
down.
Down, down.
Yes, Dennis, I like that one too. Those are the Strolls. The Strolls, originally the Phytones. Just posted this one on my Facebook wall. You can take a peek at the what I just played there. The 1959, the Strolls on Stroll, and their tune called, I think, I don't want to take the sticker off. I think they spelled down wrong or something. But it's called Down, 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 Down. As Johnny G goes down, down in the depths of the collecting hobby. We do it every Saturday right here on Top Shelf Foley's. Got another B-side from the last 50 show, as I featured the first label of this record on Impala by the Notorials, which was subsequently released on Sunbeam Records, which I also have. Could you believe otherwise? But anyway, the song was called My Valerie, but let's give a listen to the B-side of the 45 with an orchestra conducted by Franny Williamson and the Imperials. Now, Franny Williamson also owned the Impala label. This one from 59, they are the Notorials. On Impala, a song called Loved and Lost.
Love and lost.
Sides here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. 1959 there for the Notorials. Featured it on the Impala label, a song called Loved and Lost. The A-side, a song called My Valerie. That is the up-tempo side. You can also get that on the Sunbeam label, a little cheaper on the Sunbeam label. John G here spinning original vinyl 45s, 1950s and early 60s style. We are in 1959 for yet another flip side from the last 50s edition, as I played a rare one out of Cleveland, Ohio by a group called the Monarchs with an apostrophe S, yes. And the side one was called Love You, That's Why. Let's give a listen to side two from 1959, the Monarchs on Liban, Liban Records, a song called Coming Home.
I'll be there right away. at you. Back where I belong. On my way, I said, almost there, I said, I'm a jail man. I'm coming home, I said, take it easy, baby. Don't you be alarmed. Daddy's on his way. Won't do you no harm. On my way, I said, almost there, I said, I'm a jail man. I'm coming home, I said, I'm coming home.
A group called the Monarchs, 1959 on the Liban record label, song entitled Coming Home. Great two-sided 45. That's a pretty expensive record if you can find that one, yes. John G continuing here with the ultra-rare 45. It's my last record out of the 1950s. This is 1959. And the label's out of Nashville, Tennessee. Jim Bullitt and Ray Wortham's Delta label. Can't find any information about this group, though, but this is the A-side of the 45. The group is called the Candlelighters. Just posted this up on my Facebook wall. You can check it out. A photo of it. A rare record for sure. The Candlelighters from 59 on Delta. A song called... Wait, did I type that right? Would you do the same for me? The song is called Would You Do the Same for Me? I did type it right. Let's give it a spin. It's on a label called Delta Records out of Nashville, Tennessee. Very rare 45 if you're looking for that one by the Candlelighters. 1959, Would You Do the Same for Me is the name of that tune. Let's move into the early 1960s now with a rare 45 out of the state of Texas. And it's the group's debut single. They're called the Neons, not to be confused with the New York City group called the Neons that did Angel Face on Tetra back in 56. This is a totally different group. The song co-written by the lead singer, he goes by the name of Ricardo King. This one from May of 1961, the Neons on Walden. Walden Records, the name of the tune is called My Lover.
so deep. She left me all alone.
May 1961 released their group called The Neons. The Neons on the Walden label, song called My Lover. I think they're the same group that also recorded on the Challenge label, but this is definitely their better record and much harder to find, that is for sure. Let's continue. Here we are in the year 1960. You all know this next singer out of Los Angeles, California, as this was his debut single. He would go on to have some major hits during his career. I'm sure many of you know a song on the Monogram record label in 1962 called Let's Dance. Then in 1966, on the A&M record label, had a hit with a song called The More I See You. His real name is Christopher Montanez, but you know him as Chris Montez. Now, he was 17 years old when he recorded this song, written for him by Barry Dvorzin. He wrote this tune, and KDAY disc jockey Alan Freed was playing this 45, as there is an air check that you can hear that Alan Freed announces this artist and says he'll go on to bigger and better things. It was very interesting. This one charted regionally number 53 on KAIR in Tucson, Arizona. We go to Joe Carlton's Guaranteed label for this one, November 1960. This is the sound of East LA. This is the sound of East LA by Chris Montez with his debut single, a song called They Say.
About you, oh, so
November 1960 release there, Mr. Chris Montez, Guaranteed Records, song entitled They Say Yes, Dennis. Chris was wanted to be a protege of Richie Valens. He had the sound very similar to Richie, at least in his early style. And if you flip over, that's his hit, Let's Dance. The B-side of that 45 is a song called You're the One. He sounds very much like Richie Valens on that side, too. That's for sure. John G's here spinning original vinyl 45s. Let's continue here. And on the last 50s and early 60s show, I played a request for Bopper Boy Warren as he wanted to hear this Bronx, New York group called The Mood Makers. And he wanted to hear the B-side of this release on Morty Craft's Bambi label, a song called Dream a Dream. But let's give a spin to the A side of the 45 before it goes back down in the No Humidity Basement. Features Ed Jordan on lead. This one from May of 61, The Mood Makers on Bambi with their tune called Dolores.
Oh, Dolores, I love you.
Oh, before yesterday, my heart, she went astray. Oh, 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 you who came my way and made life so gay. Ha-ha, Dolores, I love you. What more could I say? Ha-ha, my heart.
Whoa,
beats,
yes,
for you.
Boom, boom, oh, Dolores, I love you.
I never knew before I met you. Oh, 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 my life was so dark. You gave a little spark. Dolores, I love you. What more could I say? My heart.
Whoa, beats, yes,
for you.
Boom, boom, boom.
They say that you'll be mine, and in your little heart I can find a place for me. 'Cause I love you, yes, can't you see? Hey, hey, before yesterday, my heart, she went astray. Oh, 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 you who came my way and made life so gay. Dolores, I love you. What more could I say? My heart,
oh,
beats,
yeah,
for you.
Boom, boom, oh, Dolores, I love you.
I remember first hearing that record on the Time Capsule show, believe it or not. But those are, I lost my place here, those are the Mood Makers, May 1961 on the Bambi label. That is the A side of the 45, a song called Dolores. Now that group, prior to becoming the Mood Makers, they were called the Five Delights. The Five Delights, they recorded on the Newport and also released on the Unart label, There'll Be No Goodbye. They do that tune, and they also do another one on the Able label, pretty rare record by the Five Delights, but there they are as the Mood Makers. Let's continue here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. Really enjoy listening to this next gal. She's from Jacksonville, Florida. Had some pretty cool records that came out on George Goldner's Gone label, also some on El Dorado. Her first one came out on Point. She has some other good ones on Cameo, and the label that I'm featuring, ABC Paramount. She used to be a regular on many of the Alan Freed rock and roll shows in New York City, and he coined her as the Blonde Bombshell. And here is her fourth of seven she recorded for the ABC Paramount record label, and this is a cover song originally recorded by the Teen Queens in 1956 on the Modern Records, I think, as I lose my place. This record was number 8 on KTKT in Tucson, Arizona. Of course, I'm talking about Joanne Campbell. Joanne Campbell from June of 61. This one on ABC, her rendition of the song Eddie, My Love.
Eddie, my love.
Cover tunes here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. That's Joanne Campbell and a group there from June 1961, ABC Paramount Records. A fourth of seven she recorded on the ABC Paramount record label. Eddie, My Love is the name of that one. Of course, the Teen Queens did that one too. Big hit for them. Really standard record. Remember listening to oldie radio, at least here in New York. You would hear that on AM radio all the time in the 70s, but no more. CBS FM is all 1970s. If you like the 70s, of course, I was a teenager in the mid-1970s, but I know all these records here. Yes, I do. Hope you're digging on the tunes tonight. Let's continue. Let's stay in 61 for this next... Let's back up here. I got a group here. Actually, Warren requested another B-side on the last 50s edition of the Vinyl Treasure Show by this Philadelphia PA group called the Blend Tones. Now, the B-side of the record was called She's Gone. Now, this record came out on three different labels originally, and first pressed on the Donnell label out of Philadelphia, then released on the Chickar label, and a third way on the Imperial label. And are you surprised that Johnny G has all three? Well, don't be, because I am a completist, that is for sure. But let's give a spin to the A side of the 45. It's a cool up-tempo tune here. I'm featuring it this time on the Chickar label. March 1961, the Blend Tones with their tune called Lights, Please. please.
You know I went to see her chick just the other night. As soon as I sit in the chair, she turned out the lights and I said,
lights please,
you're squeezing me.
Lights please,
stop teasing me.
So dark.
Pull me across the floor and I said,
lights please,
you're squeezing me.
Lights please,
stop teasing me.
So dark
that I can't see. Please turn on those lights. Baby, I know I hate to be alone, but I really got to get on. So I knew I had to stay. She said,
lights please,
you're squeezing me.
Lights please,
stop teasing me.
Completely
outside,
please turn on those lights.
Baby, I know I hate to be alone, but I really got to get on home. Let's say goodnight, let go of my sleep. I loved her so I knew I had to stay. She said,
lights please,
won't turn no on.
Lights please,
when she went on.
Completely
out of sight.
Please turn on those.
Oh,
please turn on those.
Please turn on those.
Sounds of 1961 here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. Those are the Blend Tones. That is the A side of the 45 from March 61. I featured it on the Chickar label. It's probably my best copy of that, a Stone Mint copy there, the Blend Tones, with a song called Lights Please. Hopefully you didn't lose any lights. We had some severe thunderstorms. With all this hot weather, usually it's followed by a thunderstorm. Why it happens at the end of the day, I don't know what it is. Driving home from work, you always get caught in these awful thunderstorms with this awful hot weather. I can't wait for football season and the fall. Yes, I can. But let's continue with some more 45s out of the year of 1961. Here's a female singer. I have no clue who she is. She goes by the name of Little Bessie, and this appears to be her only release, as both sides are pretty good in my opinion. But let's give a listen to the intended A side. It's on the Amy label out of New York City. The song is written by Windsor King, who was a member of the Cashmeres that recorded on the Lake label. Actually, a few releases. I think Satisfied is the record that I remember that he did as lead of the Cashmeres. But he wrote this tune for Little Bessie. It's from March of 61. It's the A side. It's on Amy. A song called Broken Hearted. No. There you go.
Bring you
Those are the records I used to find when I was collecting Group Harmony for like a quarter. Those are the records. Love to find records like that. Nice copy, too, of that one. Little Bessie's her name, March 1961, on the Amy label, a song called Broken Hearted. No need to get broken hearted yet. Almost 5 minutes to go here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. We'll do a little bit of overtime, so let's continue here for another 45. I have no info about, unfortunately. It's on Sid Nathan's King label. Now, the group may be out of Las Vegas, Nevada, though, because I say this because the song was leased from Dynamic Sound Recording Company, and they were located in Las Vegas, Nevada. It was written by Al Gemma and Frank Lendini. So two Italian guys wrote this tune. But let's give it a spin. It's from August of 61. Sid Nathan's King label, The Targets. That's the name of the group. The name of the tune is called It Doesn't Matter.
It doesn't matter, no, it doesn't matter, no, it doesn't matter at all. It doesn't matter, no, it doesn't matter, no, it doesn't matter at all.
It doesn't matter, baby, how my heart cries. It doesn't matter, darling, how much you lied. For the love we shared, it doesn't matter anymore.
It doesn't matter, no, it doesn't matter, no, it doesn't matter at all.
Your loved ones meant so much to me,
much to me.
My heart and soul was yours to be. But it just doesn't matter. It doesn't matter anymore. Those lonely nights, I cried for you, wondering where you could be. I only know God loved you so. And wanted you, right here, with me. Your love to me was just a game. But now I know you wouldn't blame. And it just doesn't matter. No, it doesn't matter anymore.
Johnny G gets caught here. That is not a bad record there. Not a bad record at all. The Targets is the name of the group. August 1961 release on Sid Nathan's King label there. Song called It Doesn't Matter. But it does matter to Johnny G because I only play original vinyl 45s, no MP3s, no CDs, just original vinyl. And this next 45 is on my not favorite type of vinyl, that being Styrene Records. As we head back out to Los Angeles, California, to Hunter Hancock's swinging label for this group called The Calendars. Now, this is not the same group that recorded on the Chattahoochee label, a West Coast Calendars group that do You Don't Fall in Love, but this is another group. The tune's written by Freddie Lee Kober and Miles Grayson. Now, Miles Grayson was a member of a group called The Echoes on the Combo label. But he co-wrote this tune. Let's give it a spin as we move into 1962. The Calendars on Swingin' and their tune called 1 Week Romance.
There is Monday.
So good to me.
They're called the Calendars. The Calendars from 1962 on Swingin' Records. Song entitled One Week Romance. Now, probably the biggest hit on the Swingin' label. Actually, they had two. I know Rochelle and the Candles was one, and there was another one by Sonny Williamson, maybe. I don't know. Or Little Somebody, I think, there was a hit on that label, at least a West Coast hit. But anyway, that's a great label to collect. The only thing is, all of the releases are styrene, I think, except their first one that comes on vinyl. And I think I forget the name of it, but it's not an easy record to find. Anyway, Johnny babbling on here. We are now in Vinyl Treasure Overtime. It's 2 minutes past midnight here. So let's continue. We are in 1962. Let's stay out in Hollywood, California. We go to the Wilder Brothers Llama label. Now, this label really didn't have any hits. Let's just say that there probably was somewhat of a hit on the label, that Dick and Dee Dee, the original release of The Mountains High, first came out on this Llama label, but they were distributed nationally, though, by the Liberty label. So I guess we can say that this label did have a hit on it. At least it was distributed locally out in the Hollywood, California area. But I don't know about this next 45, as the writers are Bob Paris and Bill Young. Now, when Charlene and I were doing some research on this, actually Charlene asked me, she said, John, I'm doing some research on this record. It was Linda Lou and the Hitmakers, and she found somewhere where it said that this was really Dee Dee of Dick and Dee Dee. So I sent her an email on Facebook. She's a Facebook friend. And I asked her, is this really you? And she hasn't gotten back to me yet, so I don't know. I don't know if it sounds like her. Maybe you guys out there know if this is Dee Dee Phelps. I think that's her name, but she wasn't Phelps when she was recording with The Mountains High. I forget her last name, but I did have it down here. But anyway, let's give it a spin here. It's from February 62. It's on the Llama label, and somebody says this is Dee Dee of Dick and Dee Dee. I don't know, but it's Linda Lou and the Hitmakers. The name of the tune is called The Torch Is Out. February 62 release there, Linda Lou and the Hitmakers on the Llama label out of Hollywood, California. Song entitled The Torch Is Out. John G's Torch is not out, even though it is after midnight. We'll continue with a few more 45s here. Let's go back to Philadelphia, PA, for this group that did all their recordings for Larry Caron's Mask label out of Philadelphia. The group consisted of Kent Peeler, Roosevelt Simmons, Tommy Cook, and Ronald Wright. Collectively, they were known as the Strangers, not the same Strangers that I played earlier with Eddie Rich. This is a totally different group for sure. Now, their first release came out on Mask in 1960, a song called I'm Feeling Sad, a pretty cool tune, but two other masters were sold by the label owner to Philadelphia DJ Kay Williams, who would in turn lease them out to Leonard Chess, and he put them out on this release on the Checker label. And it's interesting because you can see Kay Williams' name in the publishing, which is interesting. But anyway, this one is from February of 62, The Strangers on Checker, their tune called Darlin'.
Darling, if I had $1 million, I would give them up for you, just to prove to you, my darling, that my love is true.
Yes, I have to agree with those in the chat room. A super ballad there by the Strangers. February 1962 release on the Checker label. The Checker label there, song entitled Darling. Let's continue. We are in Vinyl Treasure Overtime. Up next, artist from Palestine, Texas, born December 28th, 1938. His real name was Gene Thomason. Of course, you know him as Gene Thomas. Had so many cool recordings on different labels. Now, believe it or not, his biggest hit was a duet as Gene and Debbie in 1967 on the TRX label, a song called Playboy, a 45 that my aunt bought back in 1967. But he had so many other releases, and here is one he recorded actually twice. This record first came out in 1962 on the Venus label, then again in 1964 on United Artists. And let's give a listen to the first way it came out. He resung the version in 64, but this was the original on Venus from June of 1962, Gene Thomas, and his tune called Down the Road.
feeling it's gonna get better. Father on down the road. Got a little feeling it's gonna get better, darling. Father down the road I go. I asked the gypsy to tell me what to do. If I ever really had a chance with you, gypsy told me, baby, you and I were through. So I'm moving down the road. Got a little feeling it's gonna get better. Father on down the road. Got a little feeling it's gonna get better.
June 62 release there from Mr. Gene Thomas on the Venus record label, the first time around for this tune in 62, Down the Road. Got to send this one out to Charlene Whiteside and her son Brent Whiteside. They love that tune, as they did love the Chris Montez. Forgot to mention that Charlene, of course, my administrative assistant, helps me so much on Saturdays with a lot of the research here on the program. Really does a lot for me. I appreciate it, Charlene. Thank you. That goes out to you. That's a cool tune there. Unfortunately, we lost Gene Thomas. August 12, 2012. Died at the age of 73 of lung cancer. We remember him here on the Vinyl Treasure Show and Top Shelf Oldies. Let's continue. Let's go to Philadelphia, PA again for this group's first release on the Gaiden label. They would later on record as Jimmy and the Sundials on Buddy Caldwell's V-Tone label. Really a rare 45 that I have featured here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. But this is their first release from May of 62. Features James Mathis on lead. He also wrote the song. These are the Sundials on Gaiden with their tune called Chapel of Love.
Chapel of Love.
This record player.
Chapel of Love.
Chapel of Love.
They're called the Sundials. The Sundials, May 1962. James Mathis, he's doing lead on that. He also wrote the tune on the Guidon label out of Philadelphia, PA, song entitled Chapel of Love. John G here at the Chapel of 45s. We play them every Saturday from 10 to midnight right here. We are in Vinyl Treasure Overtime. Let's flip over another 45 from the last 50s and early 60s edition. As I played the B-side of this record by a group out of Louisville, Kentucky, the side I featured was called Till I Hear It From You, but the A-side was a big regional hit for them. And it's a cover song originally done by James Brown. This one first came out on the Jam label, but I'm featuring it on the Soundstage 7. It's the first of three for the group on Soundstage 7. It was a big number three on WKLO out of Louisville, Kentucky. You would expect that. Number four on WJBK out of Detroit. It features Mike Gibson on lead. This one from January 63, The Monarchs. The Monarchs on Soundstage 7. With their rendition of the James Brown tune, This Old Heart. The Monarchs. The Monarchs from January 1963 on the Soundstage 7, originally on the Jam label, with Mike Gibson on lead there. The Monarchs with their tune called This Old Heart. They did have one national Billboard charted record. Look Homeward Angel did make the charts for them on the Soundstage 7 label. Let's continue. Here we are in Vinyl Treasure Overtime. And next up, a group out of Columbus, Ohio. They have this lone release on Phil Gary's Olympic label. Now, the lead for the group goes by the name of Kalib Talbert, but he's not doing the lead vocals on this song, even though Kalib gets writer credits. But you can call the lawyers on this one, because this song is called I'm Yours, but in reality, the song should be called You're Mine, which was first done by the Crickets in 1953 on the MGM label. So this group kind of stole the song, and they just changed the name to I'm Yours. But it's by Khalib and the Playboys, 1963 on the Olympic label. The song is called I'm Yours. It features Donnie Fisher on lead. Let's give it a spin. This one not pressed well on the vinyl, but let's just hear it.
You're mine. Now it can't be told why our love was a secret. So
Dennis, I have to agree, that's a great rendition there. The song is called I'm Yours, but really it should be You're Mine. That is for sure. That's Khalib and the Playboys, 1963, on the Olympic label. A song called I'm Yours. A lot of these Olympic presses, they don't play well. I don't know how they recorded it, but I have one by girl group The Jewels. I have a couple others on this, The Drakes, I think, and not many records on this label, but they are good ones, that is for sure. John G here in Vinyl Treasure Overtime. Let's continue for a few more. I rarely play hits. And sometimes when I do play hits, I play them definitely on their true original label, as is the case with this one. I just posted this one on my Facebook page, but I really like this song. I always did. And my aunt never had the 45, but she used to have it on a roulette compilation, I think. But I played a song by this artist on my last 60s show, believe it or not, on the MGM record label. Those of you that tuned into that 60s show, a song called If My Car Could Only Talk. I think that's the side that I played. But he is from Glen Willard, Pennsylvania. First recorded with a group called The Classics back in 1960. Had some monster hits in the early 1960s. And this was one of them. That was, a hit nationally on the Roulette label, but first came out on the C&C label. And, of course, I'm talking about Lou Christie, and I'm featuring this on the C&C label, and it was owned by Nick Sensi. So it's the first press, and it's pretty cool to hear the song on the first press. It's a nice mint copy. Well, let's give it a spin. First released in October of 62, Lou Christie on C&C, and the original version of The Gypsy Cried.
I had some trouble with my baby.
trouble with my baby. And this is what the gypsy said. The gypsy cried.
I'm sure many of you know that tune there, but have you heard it on the CNC label? That is the CNC version from October 62. Mr. Lou Christie, still going strong today. That is for sure, the Lou Christie with his big hit, a song called The Gypsy Cried. Let's continue here. Two more 45s before Johnny G signs off. Got another cover tune. This one are first recorded by the Dream Lovers back in 1962. But here is a release from sometime in 1964, early 64, on a label called Buccaneer out of the state of Mississippi. And the group is called the Caprees, C-A-P-R-E-E-S. Not an easy record to find, but it's a nice cover song. Let's give it a spin. 1964, the Caprees on Buccaneer with their version of the tune, If I Should Lose You.
If I should lose your love, my friends would laugh and say, we told you so. Each time I cry, they say, why don't you let her go? They say she'll soon break my heart. I should lose your kiss. My friends would laugh and say, we told you so. Each time I cry, they say, why don't you let her go? They say she'll soon break my heart.
Oh, cover tunes here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. 1964, a group called the Capres with two E's, C-A-P-R-E-E-S, on a label called Buccaneer Records, their rendition of the Dream Lovers song, If I Should Lose You. It's time for Johnny G to You Lose You. That's going to do it for Johnny G and the Vinyl Treasure Show. Hope you enjoyed listening to original vinyl 45s out of my collection. You want to get in touch with Johnny G, send me an email at vinyltreasures@aol.com. Also, you can reach me at johnnygvinyltreasures@gmail.com. We'll be recording this one on the Ustream broadcaster. I will get it up on my YouTube account. You'll also stream or download the shows on my website, vinyltreasures.net. It houses a lot of the older shows there, so you can always check that one out. And we're going to close the show this evening with a group called the Mandels. Now, they're not the same group that recorded on the Smart Chess label, but that group was out of Arizona, I think, Phoenix, Arizona. But this group is out of New York City, the same group that recorded You're No Good on the York label, a great tune on the York label. But this one's on Jerry Blaine's Jubilee record label, arranged by Robert Banks, produced by Earl Robinson, released in December of 65. The Mandels is the closer. The song is called True Love is Hard to Find, and that is definitely the truth. And this one also came out as the Jammers on Jubilee, so you collectors out there, check for the Jammers or the Mandels. But that's going to do it, folks. John G, glad to be back here spinning my original vinyl 45s. Hope you enjoyed the tunes, as I love to feature them for you here every Saturday. So I'll be back here next Saturday starting at 10 p.m., 10 to midnight, right here on Top Shelf Oldies. Please tune into my buddy tomorrow evening, 9 p.m., Dave the Raven, Relics and Rarities. He'll be on at 9 to midnight right here on Top Shelf Oldies. Well, everybody have a cool remainder of the weekend, or maybe next week's going to be really hot. And I will see you here next Saturday night at 10 p.m. Just want to say, everybody, so long.
You know, 'cause you know.